How many gym sessions did Arjuna run at Tungaru?
He won't do any gym sessions. It's very hard for him because we also accepted that because not only Arjuna, the few other.
Yeah, they were Aravinda, Guru Singha.
That era because it's very hard to them to push them. And also, actually, we think they can get the runs in the board. So that's more important than the fitness at the time because our thinking is so different rather than fielding and everything. So if you are a fielder, because he goes to Ranatunga, if he goes a run, we don't mind because he will contribute by batting. That's what we thought at the time. So it all changed a lot. And mostly gym sessions never heard about at the time because we haven't seen a gym. That's the way it is, was in Sri Lanka because, and if it's fitness, you say you run 4 rounds and that's it.
Yeah, that was, I was talking about, you know, gym fitness versus playing cricket fitness. So, when I saw an interview with Wasim Akram, he said, I just can't understand why fast bowlers would go and do these gym sessions. My strength muscle came from bowling in the nets. I would bowl day in and day out and develop my shoulder muscle. That's how I could bowl fast consistently. Now you have to do that. How do you strike a balance? Because having played cricket in that time where it wasn't so, but now you've changed with the times. Which do you think is the right way to go about it?
Yeah, it's a really good question. I personally believe that you need a balance. I think over the past 5 years, in most professional environments, the balance has gone too far towards sports science, where there's been more emphasis on players achieving goals in the gym and on the track than on the field of play. I believe that the training needs to be very specific to what you do. David Warner runs between the wickets like a hare and he sprints, he needs to sprint. He doesn't need to do what a fast bowler needs to do. So their training programs must be very different. Yes, there's no doubt that weights is going to complement what they do, but the main work they need to be doing is on the track. So the running that David uses, for instance, that running training is vital to his game because it gives him extra runs between the wickets, it makes him a brilliant fielder to stop runs in the field, and it's geared towards, you know, what he delivers to the team. So I think, you know, it's slowly coming back to that balance where gym is important, but let's get more emphasis on what is specific to your performance on the field of play.
Really, same question to you. I mean, like you said, didn't do gym sessions, but you have to bowl in a test match someday, you would bowl about 30 overs in a day. How did you keep yourself fit? And how do you think now, as a coach, do you advise a bowler what he needs to do?
Especially if a spin bowler, because I used to bowl about whole next session 3.5 hours, keep on bowling because that's the way I developed. And even younger days, we used to bowl a lot and lot. So nowadays people reduce their bowling and do more gym session and stuff. But still, I think nowadays people get more injured than older days because they didn't get injured. If you say Kapil Dev would have only one injury, would have been whole career playing about nearly 100 odd test matches. So that's so that's what I think sometimes Wasim Akram would have said, I didn't do gym because I was keep on bowling, because we are used to that. So now, nowadays, younger days, even 18, 19 years, they start doing gym and then bowling, they get to used to that. So if you don't do the gym sessions, then they get injured. So the patterns are changed and sports science has come and the newer generation gone through that. So older days, you bowl, keep on bowling. That's all you get, and then hardly you get injuries. These days, you have many injuries. If you say many teams, you say so many bowlers get injured every time.